So this is basically like me demonstrating what was originally Jez, I think his name was, and Poi Hardware posted how he put his Pod Poi inside these contact balls. So I set out to try it out for you guys to see if it's a good idea or not before everyone goes and spends all their money. First thing you obviously want to do is take apart your Pod Poi. There's tons of demonstrations that Flow Toys does on YouTube that can show you how to do that. I'm not going to really show it, just to save time. Okay, so when you get these balls, they have a little LED unit glued into it. So what I did was kind of like just keep pressing and peeling until it cracked a little bit in one spot. And then I just kept working around that one spot that I cracked with the X-Acto knife and kept cracking the glue all around where it's attached. And then you'll get air to pass through finally, like that. And then you can just go ahead and squeeze the whole ball down and just push the little thing up. Should come out pretty easy after you got all the glue unattached from it. This one I already pulled out, so yeah. That's what it looks like. Yep. Now I use a body reamer, an RC car body reamer. Is what I use to cut my holes and balls. You could drill whatever you want. Feed your tether through. I use 8mm cold cord. And then you're gonna want to take that little metal washer from the Pod Poi unit and melt the end of your rope. That's on YouTube also. Now that you have your tether attached to the pod unit, take the little C-ring off the end. This is where Jez went wrong. He left the C-ring on there and carved out the ball some more so it would wedge in there. I mean, it might, I'm sure it worked, but this is just so you don't have to cut the ball at all. You just wedge it in there. Okay, when you're pulling this in, it's kind of hard at first, but you get used to it. Kind of just start it in there like this. Actually, but you can get it after a while. You just kind of squeeze in there. Make sure you keep pulling your tether, feeding your tether through. Kind of screw it in there. Keep pulling on your tether. When you get to a point, you have to push it in. And it'll kind of just pop in there. It does take away some of the shape of the ball. Is not completely round, but your contact rolls still work. I'm working on something right now, possibly using a bigger ball, not sure yet. I'm thinking of using the Silex implosion balls, so you can push it in flush and it makes the bottom a little flat, not much. And the top a little egg-shaped, but not much. And, yeah. It's also pretty easy to just pop it back up. Very simple. Sometimes the O-ring will pop off right here. Sometimes not. Just be careful with all your components of your Pod Poi don't come flying out when you're yanking it in there. What's also genius about this is it solves pretty much all the weight issues I had with the Pod Poi. I'm not sure how much they weigh, and I don't really feel like weighing them for you guys. Of course I'm gonna weigh it. They came out to a whopping 188 grams. Well, how do I charge it? There. You just push it out a little. Plug your bad boy in and let it charge. Mine needed a charge, I think. Not really. This isn't a tutorial. Well, the first part of the video was kind of a tutorial how I did it, but made the Poi. This is just a demo of like how well it does contact. I'm not going to show you all my cool moves. I'm just going to show you the basics and what it's capable of doing. So here we go. That's a baller demonstration.
It's pretty good length. Pretty good length.
So your right hand has the pod poi in it, right?
Yeah.
And your left hand has the sphere. Okay. Sick. Let's see what it looks like.
They're on the same mode, I'm sure.
I'm pretty sure too.
Dude, it's not much different.